And there we go. So we want to pick up where we left off on Friday. We want to find the area beneath the curve, f of x equals x cubed, and we're going to go from 0 to 3. And we're going to use this. Area is the definite integral, so from a to b of f of x dx. That's equal to the limit as n goes to infinity of the summation from I equals 1 to n of f of x of I delta x, where delta x is b minus a over n, and x of I is a plus b minus a over n times I. Looks like a bunch of gibberish. We're going to make a lot of sense of it today. We start here. We always start with this. What's the width of n rectangles? B minus a over n, which will be 3 minus 0 over n, or 3 over n. Everybody good there? Okay. For what x values do we evaluate the sum? That would be your x sub I values. Okay. So we take 0 plus, we know what b minus a over n is. It's 3 over n. And multiply by I. We get 3i over n. I'll check it out right after we get this example. Okay. We do 2. So, now I've got the x sub I, and I've got the delta x. So what I'm going to do is express this area as a definite integral. The integral from 0 to 3, yep, of the function, what's the function? X cubed dx. That's equal to the sum from I equals 1 to n. Oh, I'm sorry, limit. The limit as n goes to infinity of the sum from I equals 1 to n of f of x sub I. So this is the first part where you need to start being not confused, okay? X sub I is 3i over n. What do we do with the 3i over n? Plug it into the x cubed. So it's 3i over n cubed times 3 over n. Why, Andrew? Yep, that's delta x, okay, and this was x sub I. So you take that delta x, you plug it in right there, so 3 over n, very good. You always start with finding the width and the x sub I values. So that's equal to the limit as n goes to infinity of the sum from I equals 1 to n of, now let's cube this and multiply. What's 3 cubed times 3? So I have 81i cubed over, yeah, I take n and cube it, and I get n cubed times n will be n to the 4th. So this is the piece I'm trying to figure out. I take my x sub I value, which is 3i over n, and I plug it into the function. And the function is x cubed. Look at what it says. It says f of x sub I. So I have n cubed is n cubed, then times the n on the bottom is n to the 4th. That's where the n to the 4th comes from. Any other questions? Anything else we didn't answer? Okay, let's factor leaving only an I. So I have the limit as n goes to infinity of, I take out the 81 over n to the 4th, times the sum from I equals 1 to n of, what's left if I factor that out? I cubed. I factored the 81 over n to the 4th off. Don't need to. It's all multiplication. I cubed, that means we start at 1,
So 1 plus, then we plug it in 2, you get 8. You plug in 3, you get 27. Plug in 4, you get 64. 125 plus dot, 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 plus n cubed. So the question is, what do those add up to? Right there. Is everybody clear where I got that? Is my substitution? So let's find the limit. I have the limit as n goes to infinity of, multiply that top out. What am I going to get? 81 n to the 4th. So take n plus 1 squared. You're going to get an n squared times n squared. N plus 1 times n plus 1. I'm sorry, or n times 1 plus n times 1. So 2n times n squared. 2n cubed times 81. 162 n cubed. Of 1 times 1 times n squared times 81. All over, 4n to the 4th, what do we factor out of the top? N to the 4th, you can factor out the 81, but you sure don't need to. 81 plus 2 over n plus, oh, I'm sorry, 162 over n. Was 81 over n squared. All over what? 4 in the 4th. What happens? N to the 4th cancel. And Aaliyah says that the 162 over n and the 81 over n squared, those go to 0 because the limit's going to infinity. Or n's going to infinity. So we're left with 81 over 4. Which is 20.25. That almost looked too easy. Like, could I take x cubed and calculate the area, number 7, from 0 to 3, and would I get 20.25? Well, Gina, louder, please. That's beautiful right there. So that's where I take this and I put that in its place. All right. Michael, let me check the video right after lunch, okay? All right, last example for the day, okay? And then you guys can have some time to work on this. What's different about example 6? Okay, it's got a messed up equation. It's a gross function. Okay, how about this? The function has two parts to it. It has two terms. So I'm going to show you today, right now in this lesson, how to handle if it has more than one term. Okay? And notice that we're continuing to start at 0 each time. It's easier if you start at 0. Tomorrow I'll show you if you start at 1 or 2 or 3. Just a little trick. But we start here. What's the width of n rectangles? 4 over n. What x values do you evaluate the sum? Or I over n. Are we good with that? So therefore, therefore the area from 4 to 0 of 2x minus 1 over 2x squared dx is equal to the limit as n goes to infinity of the sum from I equals 1 to n. And here's where I get lost. So 2 times 4i over n. No. Minus 1 half times 4i over n squared. Now, Jake. Times 4 over n. So I have to plug the 4i over n in for each of the x spots. Fortunately, we're really good at mathematics, and so that's going to make this not too bad. It's going to be a little while before we're able to factor something out, but we have the limit as n goes to infinity of the sum from I equals 1 to n of 2 times 4i over n, 8i over n, minus... Sixteen I squared over, how about 2n squared? Can we do that? That's all multiplied by 4 over n. Yep. 4 squared is 16. And you get 2 at the bottom. So I have the limit as n goes to infinity, the sum from I equals 1 to n. Let's distribute that 4 through, 4 over n through, and what do we get? 16i over, well, not 16, 32i over n squared, minus, now 16 over 2 is just 8, right? So what do we get in the numerator? 32i squared over n cubed. Okay, getting closer here. I'm gonna separate this into two sums. And so if you have two terms, you're gonna wanna go with two sums. If you have three terms, you're gonna go with three sums. But one thing I want you to notice right away, notice that the I here is the first part, but the n is squared. Notice the I is the second part, but the n is cubed. See how it's 1 degree off? That's really important because look at our formulas over there. Yeah, they're all 1 degree off, aren't they? Okay, so we have the limit as n goes to infinity of the sum from I equals 1 to n. Whoop, what do I want to put in front of that guy? What do I want to factor out of the first piece? Yep, 32 over n squared times the sum from I equals 1 to n of I minus, what do I want to take out of the second one? 32 over n cubed of the sum from I equals 1 to n of I squared. So I'm just going to separate to two sums. So this guy was one sum, this was another sum. Just gonna separate it in two pieces. Now, we are going to get rid of these summation expressions. Do we have things that could go in those places? Sure do. If you don't believe me, we could do some math induction and prove it all over again. Okay. So I've got 32 over n squared times what? What goes in that spot? N times n plus 1 divided by 2 minus Sweet. Let's find that limit. What are you getting in the top for the first part? Because you're dividing by the 2 right away. Okay, so 16n squared plus 16n over n squared. Good. Minus, you don't have to reduce right away. We can just do it later. Let's see. 2n times an n is 2n squared times n is 2n cubed times 32. 64n cubed. And then when I multiply these binomials together, what am I going to get in the middle? We got 2n times 1 and 1 times n. 3n times n is 3n squared times 32. 96n squared. What's your last term going to be? 32n all over 6n cubed. We're almost there. What do we take out of the top? N squared. What are you left with? What do you take out of the next set? N cubed, you're left with 64 plus 64 plus. That's all over. And that's what we'll finish up. We get back and we'll be done. Go get some brain food. Come back smarter, folks. We've got that limit. What do we do? Cross off the n squareds and the n cubes. Good. Why? Why is it going to zero? Oh, wow. You guys brought your A game today. Yeah, 6 days there. So I've got 16 minus 64 over 6 would be 32 over 3. Or 48 over 3 minus 32 over 3. 16 thirds, which is 5.3 repeating. I mean, what are the odds we actually got that right? But, I mean, we totally could have made a mistake, right? Probably we made a mistake. I'm guessing we made a mistake somewhere. I mean, there's no way we got that whole thing right. But adding up the area of an infinite number of rectangles, I mean, that's pretty much impossible. There's no way we can do that. So, what? Ah! There it is! Unbelievable! We must be the smartest people on the planet. Amazing. You are currently able to do problems 1, 2, 3, and 4 from your worksheets. Go.